Your doctor has recommended a procedure, laparoscopic radical prostatectomy, to treat your prostate cancer. Before we talk about the procedure, let's review some information about the prostate and your medical condition. The prostate is located under the bladder and behind the penis. It is a walnut-sized gland that is part of the male reproductive system. It helps make semen. The urethra is a tube that carries both urine and semen to the penis. It passes through the prostate, which surrounds it like a donut. Prostate cancer is the second most common cancer in men. It usually occurs in men age 50 and older, and those men that have a family history, especially a father or brother with prostate cancer. But the highest risk is for men that are African American and over age 70. The treatment of your cancer will depend on many factors, including the size, spread, and type of cancer, your age, and health. The options that you may have considered are watch and wait, medication including hormones, radiation therapy, and/or surgery. It is very important that you understand why this surgery has been recommended for you. If you have questions, ask. Radical prostatectomy is surgery to remove the whole prostate gland, some nearby tissue, and lymph nodes. Everything removed is tested to be sure the cancer has not spread. This surgery is only used as a treatment if the prostate cancer is still in the prostate. If the cancer has already spread, then surgery does not help and can cause serious problems when other treatments are used. In fact, if during surgery the surgeon finds that the cancer has already spread and is outside of the prostate, the procedure is stopped and other more effective treatments for the situation are planned. Your surgeon has recommended a laparoscopic surgical procedure. A long instrument with a light and camera, called a laparoscope, is used. The scope makes it possible for your surgeon to see and operate on hard-to-reach, delicate tissue. This is minimally invasive surgery that uses very small incisions instead of a classic large incision. Healing and return to normal activity is usually faster, with less bleeding and fewer complications. With all laparoscopic procedures, the surgical team is prepared to change your surgery to an open procedure with a larger incision if this becomes necessary. An open procedure is sometimes needed to treat unexpected bleeding or other findings during a procedure that make it impossible to do using a laparoscope. If this happens, your stay in the hospital and recovery will be longer than you originally expected. Be sure you understand why a laparoscopy has been recommended for you. Now let's talk a little more about what happens during a laparoscopic radical prostatectomy. General anesthesia and medications to make you asleep and pain-free during your procedure are given. A tiny incision is made and your abdomen is filled with CO2. Carbon dioxide gas. Other small incisions are made as needed for the surgeon to place tools that are used to cut, stitch, move, and remove tissue for the procedure. The bladder is gently separated from the prostate. The connection of the prostate to the bladder is cut. And then the connection to the urethra. The surgeon is careful to protect the nerves necessary for you to control your erections and urination. However, damage to the nerves may be necessary or unavoidable in removing your prostate. The prostate is carefully placed in a bag and removed through a small incision. This way, no cancer cells are spread. Finally, the bladder is stitched back to the urethra. The surgical area is carefully inspected for bleeding, and a surgical drain is placed. The instruments and gas are removed. The incisions are closed.